Hi, Chris here, co-founder of the Good Days program, and I hold a Master of Science. This is the first episode on a series of videos on migraine and science. If you followed my webinars on food and weather, this video and the following ones will refresh your memory and we will go into the details. If you haven't, let's see together what science says about migraine and how to get control over it. First step, the Migraine Threshold Theory. A few facts to start with. Migraine is a chronic condition from which about 1 person out of 7 suffer or will suffer during their lives. This is about 1 billion of us. Migraine, although not life-threatening, is a severe neurological condition with symptoms that can be extremely decapacitating. World Health Organization classifies it as one of the most decapacitating diseases, together with other conditions such as quadriplegia or terminal stage cancer. As we speak, neurologists are yet to identify the cause or the causes of migraine. They have developed a model that explains migraine risk, when symptoms appear, and how to prevent them. This model is called the Migraine Threshold Theory. And a word of caution, cause and triggers are two different things. A trigger starts something that is primed to happen, while a cause is the reason for something to happen. Remember, as of today, the causes of migraine remain widely unknown. So, what do we know then? We know that people suffering from migraine have hypersensitive brain receptors that probably trigger migraine symptoms. Let's represent a couple of these brain receptors. Exposure to migraine risk can upset these brain receptors, then symptoms appear. Such symptoms are not limited to the headache phase of the migraine attack. They also include all symptoms from prior phases, prodrome or aura. We will now focus on migraine risk. To measure migraine risk, let's imagine a specific device, the risk meter. The risk meter would be similar to a bulb thermometer. The orange liquid would indicate the level of risk at any time, and the red dash would indicate the migraine threshold. If the orange liquid level goes down, risk is decreasing. If it goes up, risk is increasing. And if it reaches the threshold, brain receptors get upset, and then symptoms appear. To summarize, on and above the migraine threshold, symptoms. Below the migraine threshold, no symptoms. Stay below the migraine threshold to remain migraine-free. Let's do a quiz to test your knowledge on the migraine threshold. First question, what is the migraine threshold? Answer A, a maximum height. Answer B, a high temperature. Answer C, a risk exposure level. Answer D, none of the above. You may want to pause the video if you need more time. Ready? If you answered C, congratulations. The risk meter is measuring risk. The threshold is the highest dash on the risk meter, so it is a risk level. If you gave any other answer, you get an upset brain receptor badge. Ready to go on? Next question, when do I get prodrome or aura? Answer A, after the threshold is reached. Answer B, just before the threshold is reached. Answer C, one day before the threshold is reached. Answer D, anytime. The correct answer is A, after the threshold is reached. As I said earlier, prodrome and aura are two different phases of a migraine attack with specific symptoms, such as yawning or visual issues. And symptoms appear once the threshold has been reached and the brain receptors upset. If you answered A, great, you're on your way to become a migraine warrior. If you answered B, C or D, you get an upset brain receptor badge. Ready to go on? Last question, what does cause migraine? Answer A, too much exposure to migraine risk. Answer B, hypersensitive brain receptors. Answer C, stress and weather changes. Answer D, nobody knows. The correct answer is D, nobody knows. As I said at the beginning, as of today, researchers do not know the causes of migraine yet. Too much exposure to migraine risk will upset brain receptors, but not cause migraine. Hypersensitive brain receptors may trigger migraine attacks, but not cause migraine. Stress and weather changes are commonly reported factors of migraine risk, but they do not cause migraine. If you did not answer correctly, you get an upset brain receptor badge. So, how did you perform? Please let me know in the comments. If you have one or more upset brain receptor badges, you may want to take a few minutes and review the video so that you get more familiar with the migraine threshold concept. It's a key concept and I will refer back to it repeatedly in the coming videos. Key takeaway on the migraine threshold theory. The migraine threshold is the maximum level of risk that you can tolerate. Stay below the migraine threshold to remain free of symptoms. In the next episode, we will see how risk and threshold vary. See you in the next episode.